Welcome back to Wolf Wednesday. I'm Heather Fox with Techpology, and today we're talking about off-leash but in control. So the three things we're going to talk about today are: when is it okay to be off-leash? What is the secret to having an off-leash dog? And some things to think about. So number one, when's it okay to have an off-leash dog? When is it okay to have your dog off-leash? The answer is going to be in public spaces, whatever is designated and legal. For personal space, it's whatever you can physically manage your dog on. Even if you have a really big backyard, if your dog is able to get out or doesn't come back to you, it doesn't necessarily mean they should be off-leash. Now, number two, what are the secrets to an off-leash dog? How do you get an off-leash dog? The answer is hard work. It's an investment. It's the small day in and day out, what you spend your time on, that's going to come around later when your dog wants to listen to you. When they come back, they have great recall. So great recall is going to be one. It's going to be using that long line leash, which looks something like this. When you're using the long line, it's going to be a tool that if they choose not to come back to you, because you know that they know how to, they just may choose not to, can you reel them back in? Do you have that security? So using that long line, using the recall, having basic commands, and building a really good relationship with your dog is a secret. So having that affection, that respect, and that trust. Now, number three, some things to think about. Even if your dog is amazing off leash, there are dogs out there that are terrified of other dogs, that have PTSD, where they may have had a really bad incident with dogs rushing up to them. So this is something that people, when we have great, friendly, lovable dogs, we don't think about this aspect all the time, that just because our dogs are friendly doesn't mean that other people's dogs are friendly. So when we have them off leash in undesignated areas, even if they kind of go off for a minute or go say hi to somebody, that's something we want to think about, because some people are afraid of dogs. Some dogs are afraid of dogs. Not everybody wants to say hi to a friendly dog running up to them. So if we do not have control or management with our dogs, they should not be off leash. If it is illegal, they should not be off leash. So any area that is designated as a public space that allows off-leash dogs or has a barrier or a fence is recommended. Because sometimes we may have a really good management with our dog, but we can't manage the outside world. We can't manage traffic. We can't manage a deer that jumps out of nowhere. So it's good to just have those common practices. So those are things to think about. So we hope you learned something today. Please check out our episode with Rocky the Farm Dog to look a little bit on how to use the long line leash. Also, you can use our feature, Text Techpology, where you can sign up to have a monthly subscription to Text a Behaviorist. So if you want to do that, just sign up here, text this number. Number two, you can go and subscribe on the Positive Pet Community and get all the tips and tricks and videos right to you when they come out. And finally, if you'd like to contribute to the Aurora Blue Initiative, all you have to do is Venmo Techpology. Each dollar goes back to your community, and that's going to be complimentary training for those that may not be able to afford it when they have an aggressive dog. Remember, not everybody signs up for an aggressive dog. They are gifted to us, or we discover it too late. So that's why with the Aurora Blue Initiative, we are giving back to the community, and we are taking those funds and making them available to those who have aggressive dogs, so we have a safer community out there. Thank you, everybody, for joining us for Wolf Wednesday. We'll see you next week.